Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Plus one, H shares the so-called mainstream media thought they finally nailed Donald Trump. When it was revealed that Trump's attorney Michael Cohen would be willing to testify against the president to Robert Mueller, journalists finally thought the smoking gun had emerged that would lead to Trump's impeachment. But the smoking gun backfired and the media ended up with egg all over their faces. The June 2016 Trump Tower meeting between Donald Trump Jr. and a group of Russians is the closest thing the media and anti-Trump investigators have to collusion. Trump Jr. took the meeting after a music producer he knew emailed him that a Russian lawyer wanted to meet to discuss dirt she had on Hillary Clinton and that it was part of the Russian government's plan to help Trump in the election. This turned out to be a complete nothing burger when it was revealed that no information about Clinton changed hands and that the true purpose of the meeting was to lobby the Trump campaign on supporting the repeal of the Magnitsky Act, which leveled sanctions against Russian adoptions over human rights abuses. All the participants in the meeting testified to the Senate Intelligence Committee. The meeting had nothing to do with collusion of the Russian government. Trump Jr. also testified that Donald Trump had no advance knowledge of the meeting. But now Michael Cohen is threatening to upset the apple cart. Cohen is under intense legal pressure after the FBI raided his home and office in April. Experts believe he could be indicted on campaign finance violations or because of his involvement in a taxi cab medallion business. Cohen is now sending out word through the media that he is willing to spill his guts to Robert Mueller. And Cohen is willing to specifically allege that Donald Trump knew of the Trump Tower meeting in advance. Journalists' hearts began to race because they thought they finally found the testimony that would bring down Trump. There is just one problem with Cohen's allegations: they are false. When Cohen testified behind closed doors to the Senate Intelligence Committee, Cohen stated that Donald Trump did not know about the meeting. And after Donald Trump Jr. also testified about the meeting, Cohen tweeted that Trump Jr. was honest and transparent. Even Rhino Senator Lindsey Graham, who is no fan of the president, said Cohen's claims were suspect, stating, "I am tired of having President Trump tried in the media. This is the oddest way to communicate with Mueller, to leak a story to NBC News that you got some new information about the Russia meeting regarding President Trump. I've been a lawyer all my adult life, I've never seen that work. That's a media strategy. So I know what Cohen had said in the past about President Trump not knowing anything about this meeting. He is on the record, Cohen is. So if you have got something new to say, don't leak it to NBC News. You need to come to either the Judiciary Committee, the Intel Committee, or both and be willing to say what you are going to say under oath. And to every American, if I were you, I would be very suspicious of Michael Cohen right now." The weekend began with the media giddy over a possible smoking gun that would prove Trump colluded with the Russians and that Congress should impeach him. But like all the other supposed bombshells, this one fizzled out and the media was left fuming that their plan to force the president from office had failed yet again.